Okay, now we're going to work on exporting your recording and uploading it to the internet. For that, I'm going to bring back my Camtasia window. Later on, we're going to cover the different parts of this window. But at this time, I would like you to go to this menu called Share and click in there. You're going to see different options to export your video. At this moment, I would like you to select Export. You're going to be asked to select a name for your recording and the location where you would like to save it. In this case, for this recommended quality, I would like you to select higher quality and then click on export. This rendering of the video normally takes a long time, or a lot longer time than when you produce other types of media. And I do recommend that whenever you produce videos like these, you take the length of this rendering process in consideration. The same goes for the final uploading of the file to the internet. So at this moment, I'm gonna pause my recording and I'm gonna come back to it when it is close to finish. Okay, it is almost there. Once that the rendering has been completed, you will get this option to reveal your file in the Finder. And here it is. Before uploading your file to the internet, you might want to double-click on it so you can take a good look at what it is, the final result of your production. And now I'm going to work on uploading this file to the internet. The first step is how to upload it to YouTube, and I am not going to cover the details about how to create an account with Google, but it's available for everyone. And once that you create that account with YouTube, the uploading of the file is as simple as clicking and dragging. YouTube goes through two different processes. The first process is to upload the file to the server. And once that is done, the second process is to reformat or implement another codec into the video so it can be shown on YouTube. Very well, the process is almost done. And now the second process of reformatting or applying a different codec to the video is taking place. Once that is done, you're going to be able to select among different video thumbnails for your video, and you're going to have these options over here to make your video public, unlisted, or private. Click on Done. The next one is to upload the video to Google Drive, and it works in the same way as YouTube does. It doesn't matter what you select here, click on Start Upload. And the process is going to be similar to the process that took place in YouTube. First, the file is going to be uploaded, and then it's going to go through a process of reformatting. Okay, it's almost done. And there it is. If you open this recording right away after you uploaded it, chances are you will not get to see it in the browser. But give Google a little bit of time and you're going to be able to see your video here. And the interface is going to be very similar to YouTube's, but it's in Google Drive. Once the reformatting has taken place, you're going to see it appear in your browser just as it does in YouTube, and it's going to have similar controls. You're going to have a play button, a volume, quality, and so on. Also, as it happens with Google Drive documents, you're going to have the ability to share it publicly or with specific people. But we're going to cover details about these later on in the tutorial. Now we're going to upload your file to a regular server like the one that you have access to in your university. In this case, I just selected one of the folders on the server in my university, and I am gonna also click and drag the video in there. Once that the recording has made it, I'm just gonna make sure that it plays in the browser.
Hello, this is the non-popular website that I would like to share with my colleagues.
And there it is. I got a video that covers almost the full screen of the browser. And even though your server might not be a streaming media server, chances are it will stream because the file that we uploaded is an MP4 file. So those are the three different methods that we covered here to upload your brand new recording onto the internet. And now you have a good idea of what entails recording one of these videos, how to upload them to the internet for your students to experience them.